Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. Today I want to do a review on the HK45 Compact Tactical. It's a full-size 45, and you guys know that I love HK products. They seem to be pretty high-quality guns. I haven't had any problems with them yet. So I'm going to talk about that and do a little comparison with the HK45. I want to talk about the ammunition I'm going to be shooting today, the Blazer Brass Black Pack. Usually these packs come with like four or five boxes with 50 rounds in them. But this is different in that it just comes with one big Ziploc bag. And it has like a little moisture absorber pack in here, somewhere in here. And should be pretty interesting, about 300 rounds. We'll see how that works out. Okay, HK45. Before I talk about the Compact Tactical, I'm gonna talk about the HK45 in general. It's a full-size gun. It's developed for a government project. They wanted to compete for a contract. And essentially, they canceled the project. They sort of designed this to be a refined version of the HK USP 45. And here's an example of, oh boy, if I can get it out, of the HK USP 45 tactical. But they decided to come out with a more refined version with better ergonomics. And they decided to go with this refined version. And it does have a smaller grip. The trade-off between this and a USP 45 is that the USP 45 had 12 round capacity, where this only has the HK 45 only has a 10 round capacity. So it's a very good gun. There's some things I don't like about it, but getting to the review of the HK 45 Compact Tactical, you can get the HK 45 Compact without the that version. Differs from this version in that it doesn't come with a threaded barrel. Now the Compact Tactical, when you get the threads, first of all, this is very difficult to get off. And when I first got it in the store, it was extremely difficult. We had to use tools or something to get this thing off. I actually had a salesperson try to get this damn thing off. It was only that tight. It's not righty, tighty, lefty, loosey or anything like that. It's actually the opposite. If you don't have the thread, you can actually go online and you should be easily be able to get it. But what's interesting about this is that it does have a long, pretty long barrel. Now, when you compare it to the HK45, the slide is actually longer. The HK45 has a longer slide, okay? But the barrel in the HK45 Compact Tactical is actually longer than the regular HK45, which is interesting. They can come in double action, single action type of guns. There's different variants. Some of them are just double action only. What's interesting with this version, you essentially have a decocker, and you also have a safety, okay? With the HK45, this HK45 Compact Tactical actually comes with just a decocker, which I really, really like. I can live with both of them. The good thing about this one is that you don't have to worry about accidentally turning on the safety. So that's a pretty good thing right there. Their magazine releases are different from standard buttons in that you press down on this, you can use this finger, release the magazine, or you can come over here and use your thumb and drop it. And I usually use my thumb. Now, I don't like this magazine release as much as the other one because this one actually goes above the trigger. It actually goes above the trigger guard. And that leaves a little bit more room, makes it easier for somebody to inadvertently drop the magazine. I have long, crooked fingers, so it doesn't really happen to me anymore, but you know, once you learn to grab the gun tightly and with a good grip and put pressure in the right areas, you're fine. Now with this design, so like the HK USP 45, it goes underneath the trigger guard, so your hands are already there anyway. You never really have to worry about inadvertently touching this magazine release. So I do like that design a lot more. What's really fascinating is that the full size version and the Compact Tactical has the same magazine capacity. Now the HK 45 Compact usually comes with a 7-round magazine that's flush with the gun. Okay, but you can get the extended one, which is standard with the HK 45 Compact Tactical, with the elephant foot, and that gives you 10 rounds, just like with the HK 45. They both, of course, have decockers, they're hammer fire guns. You break them down pretty much the same way, take the magazine out. Well, this way, with the threaded barrel, you gotta take off the barrel, the thread protector, then you push it back. You line this up, line a little notch out, then you come over here and push this in, then you pull this out. you pull this in like that, and you can break the gun down just like that. So, and you put it together the pretty much the same way. So, these are some quality guns. The prices have dropped recently because they're now making them in the U.S. Now, the difference between the U.S. version and the German version is that the German versions usually have a DE right here on the side. Now, if you want to know how old the gun is, you go over to this end, and it shows you alphabets. A means 0, 1 means B. So if there's a B there, that means 1. And if there's an H, you know, it's like A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, so there you go. That was pretty much made in 17. 1-7, so that's 17. But anyway, just a little information there in case you guys didn't know about that. Oh man, I always screw it up when I try to put this thread protector on. Another thing I should highlight is that the sights, these are actually with the Compact Tactical, they actually have night sights on here, real night sights on here. Whereas the HK45 simply comes with glow-in-the-dark lights. You put a flashlight up to it and it glows in the dark very brightly for about 5 to 10 minutes. With this, you don't need to do that with a flashlight. It's always glowing. But not as bright as the glowing-in-the-dark lights. What's also interesting is that these are not raised sights. You can put a suppressor on here. And usually when you have a suppressor on the gun, you want to have raised sights so the sights can give you a picture above the actual suppressor. But this doesn't actually do that. I don't use suppressors, so that's not really a big deal for me. So, something to keep in mind. Once again, peacocker only. They have different versions of this, different versions you can actually go with. So there's a really, I like HK's, I don't know what type of, they have a hostile environment finish over their guns. So they seem to be pretty good guns. Hostile environment finish, they don't scratch very easily, and they seem to hold up over time. This one right here, this is a pretty old one, older one, 2004 version. This is a HK USP 45 Tactical, and again, the slide looks really, really good. I haven't fired it yet, but let's check it out today. So anyway, I'm going to fire this gun soon. I'll give you my final thoughts. Definitely gotta tighten that up. It's shooting too low. It's interesting how, you know, it doesn't feel like you're shooting a big bore gun. You know, the recoil doesn't seem like a big deal with this type of gun. Haven't had any problems with the magazines or the springs being too tight or anything like that. You know, things seem to be well made and. Yeah, I was shooting low at first. Now it's getting better. That's the thing about not shooting for a while, you know? It's a perishable skill for sure, you know? You just forget how to hold each gun if you go too long without actually shooting. So, it's important that I get to the range. It's easy to forget stuff, you know? You can still shoot, but you can't shoot as effectively when you don't really shoot often enough. That's something that's important to me. Now, I was sort of talking about American-made versus German-made. The German ones are more expensive. They're starting to make them more in the U.S. now. So they're making them in Georgia, so the price is a lot cheaper. It used to be around like $1,000 or $1,100. Now it's closer to $700, $800 or so to get the HK45 and HK45 Tactical, which is much more reasonable. So I don't see a difference in the quality between the American and the German. The American-made ones seem to be pretty well made. You know, I don't feel like, oh, this sucks. Quality's dropping. I don't feel like the quality's dropped at all. Okay, that's better. Okay. Still need to tighten
okay,
it up.
Final thoughts. Would I carry this? Yes, as a big guy, I would carry this as a concealed carry piece. I prefer Glock because they're still simpler guns. If I was to carry this, I wouldn't carry the one with the safety, the external safety. This will be a better model to really carry because it just has a decocker. I would probably carry with one of the chamber pores, and I just basically carry with that and use a decocker. If the first shot, of course, will be it'll be double action. It'll be a heavier pull, but after that, the shots will be a lot easier. Same thing, a lot less pressure. So, compact tactical would be good for home defense. It has a rail system that's easy for you to mount lights onto it. One thing I should also highlight is that the grip is different than, you know, the HK45. The full size one has like a Spider-Man design, different texture, and it's like a finger grooves in there. This one does not. Some people prefer the more of a 1911 type of grip. You know, this they both have a similar angle to the 1911. They're not as extreme as maybe a Glock would be. So, all right, guys, that pretty much concludes my review of the HK45 Compact Tactical. Highly recommended. Very reliable. Very robust. I don't think I worry about parts breaking off too easily or anytime soon. If you're looking for quality, this is a good way to go. And the magazines are pretty solid too. You will pay more for the magazines, but sometimes you might find them on sale for $40. HK45, actually, sometimes they're more expensive, a little bit harder to find, but you can, if you search the websites and wait for the right time, you can find them on sale for around $40. Understand that you're not gonna find a lot of these magazines in regular stores unless you're dealing with an HK dealer. So keep that in mind. Thank you guys for watching.